Hello, I'm Jeremy, and welcome back to Jeremy Yu's Music Reviews. I listen to music, and you hear my thoughts. Well, seeing as I reviewed both Flower Boy and Call Me If You Get Lost, it only makes sense that I review Tyler's most beloved album, IGOR. Like I said in the Flower Boy review, Flower Boy will always be Tyler's magnum opus. But if Flower Boy didn't exist, then IGOR would be Tyler's best album. Why? Well, you're about to find out. This is IGOR. I like this cover. While it is the traditional artist face cover, the face is very wonky and collage-like, and combined with the pink background makes an ordinarily lazy image feel iconic. Nice work. Like Suburbia Overture from the Normal album, IGOR's opening track, IGOR's Theme, does a good job of letting the listener know what IGOR is going to be like. Let's start with the production. While Suburbia Overture is an audio roller coaster with constant production shifts, the production for IGOR's Theme mostly stays the same, starting with a long, unchanging beeping noise with drums and trap skitters added on top of it, staying that way until we slowly transition into a calming piano sound. It's overall very unique, lovely, and appropriately Tyler-esque. As for the vocals, well, IGOR's Theme is more about the production than the vocals, but they're really good. Tyler is great as usual, Solange is good, and Lil Uzi Vert blends into Tyler's world so perfectly it doesn't even sound like him. Three very good vocal performances. And the lyrics, they're kind of simple. Not really much to talk about. They're not bad per se, but they're too simple to really say anything about. But that simplicity adds a lot to the vibe of the song, so these lyrics work. IGOR's Theme is just a very good opener, with good vocals, alright lyrics, and unique production that really lets you into the world of IGOR. A great start so far. Don't leave, it's my fault. EARFQUAKE was the first Tyler song I ever heard and is easily his most recognizable and successful song. And man, was it a good introduction. Let's start with the production, and my god, is it immaculate. Lovely synths, a beautiful piano, and heavenly trap skitters. The production for EARFQUAKE is so vibey, immaculate, and beautiful that it gives Forward from Flower Boy a run for its money. A++ production. And god, does Tyler sound beautiful. His voice is the perfect blend of smooth and rough, really making the song stick out and give the audience an emotional attachment to the song in the process. I get why people like Mode Reviews might not dig his performance, but I think it's really lovely and works both with the song and IGOR's aesthetic. Oh, and Playboi Carti is on this song as well. He's great. He's an overall okay artist, but Carti's verse on EARFQUAKE is really beautiful and makes an already great song feel even greater. Great job, Mr. Carti. And the lyrics. These lyrics are just amazing. They manage to paint Tyler's desperation to reclaim his failing relationship in a way that's both incredibly poignant and brilliantly Tyler-esque. Just absolutely incredible lyrics. EARFQUAKE is the quintessential Tyler the Creator song. While it's not Tyler's best song, in my opinion, that's Forward, EARFQUAKE is just a perfect amalgamation of everything that makes Tyler the Creator awesome. Beautiful, creative, and vibey production, unique and amazing vocals, and lyrics that are as poignant and deep as they are creative and introspective. If you haven't heard EARFQUAKE yet, please do. It's just one of those songs you need to hear at some point in your life. Feelings, that's what I'm pulling. What the fuck is your motive? Man, I wish you would call me by your name because I'm sorry. I think is a very enjoyable track. Let's start with the production, and I really like it. The production for I Think is very toe-tapping and vibing, having a memorable and catchy melody, nice synths, and very warm pianos. And at the end, it gets very quiet and introspective. Very nice production all around. Tyler also sounds fantastic. His voice is very deep sounding and has a doubtful and questioning vibe, which fits the vibe of the song and sounds really good. It's an all-around enjoyable and fitting vocal performance. And the lyrics are very cool too. It's about Tyler realizing he's in love and trying to come to terms with that fact. It's a very good premise that Tyler executes in his own way. I Think is just a very cool, simplistic, and awesome song with great production, very enjoyable vocals, and effective lyrics. Definitely a track worth checking out.
Just chasing it and just like trying, giving it everything that you can. There's always an obstacle.
Exactly what you run from, you end up chasing is a very good interlude. It's relaxing, cool, and does a good job of breaking up the momentum of Igor. Not much to say, but a pretty good interlude all around. Running out of time, running out of time, running out of time. Running out of time is really cool. Let's start with the production, and it's really nice production. It's very atmospheric, with digital pianos, what sounds like a theremin, and nice glitchy sounds. It really gives the song a sense of atmosphere and makes it feel unique. Tyler also sounds great. His performance is very emotional and poignant, and the high voice makes Running Out of Time stand out as a piece of music. All in all, a nice performance. And the lyrics are really great. They're very heart-wrenching, showing Tyler's failing relationship in a really sad and emotional way. They're really well-done lyrics that perfectly match the tone and atmosphere of Igor. Running Out of Time is just a very enjoyable song that brilliantly shows Tyler's heartbreak over his failed relationship only in a way he could. Great stuff. Roll the dice, hit a seven, show you right. Beginner's luck. New Magic Wand is freaking awesome. Let's start with the production, and it's really cool. It starts out with the guy from Exactly What You Run From, You End Up Chasing, and then it starts to give off a spooky, haunted house sort of vibe. It has eerie synths, cool creepy laughter, and an awesome cowbell. It's brilliantly unique and It's brilliantly unique and enjoyably Tyler-esque production. Tyler himself also sounds great. His reflective and meek voice really reflects the haunted house vibe of the song and perfectly shows the pain he's feeling. And the lyrics are great. They're incredibly emotional, creative, and like Running Out of Time, perfectly shows Tyler's worry about his failing relationship. Nicely done. New Magic Wand is just a very interesting, clever, and cool song with great production, fantastic vocals, and interesting lyrics. A-plus job, Tyler. A Boy Is a Gun is a fantastic song. Let's start with the production and wow. It's so relaxing and enjoyable. It perfectly captures the relaxing and soothing vibe of Flower Boy while still feeling like it fits inside Igor. It's incredibly relaxing, breezy, and vibey, but also feels kind of off, which gives the impression that while things are alright on the outside, inside they're anything but. And those digital piano strokes are also awesome. Just absolutely fantastic production. And Tyler sounds great. His voice is so soft and smooth, working with the relaxing and cool production to give us a satisfyingly relaxing and breezy performance. And the lyrics are really good too. They're really interesting, using a gun metaphor to display the conflicting emotions Tyler is feeling. All in all, fantastic lyrics. A Boy Is a Gun is a fantastic song that perfectly captures the vibey atmosphere of Flower Boy while still being its own thing, with great production, fantastic vocals, and cool lyrics. Definitely an album highlight. I'm your puppet. You control me. solo. Puppet is so insanely good. Let's start with the production, and my God, is it relaxing. The production for Puppet is so soothing and glittery. It has a very lovely, warm, and nice vibe, but like with Boy and a Gun, the production feels kind of off, making it clear not all is as it seems. It's very nice, Tyler-esque production that really fits the vibe of the song. Tyler's voice is also great. His soothing voice and dejected vibe really fit the atmosphere of the song, and really makes Puppet stand out. And Kanye West also adds a lot of atmosphere and coolness as well. As for the lyrics, they're really interesting. They show the positives and negatives of being in love and how it can be controlling, hence the title of the song being Puppet. Really great stuff. Puppet is just a really cool, enjoyable track. It's a really interesting analysis on the upsides and downsides of being in love, and has a good Kanye verse to boot. Easily one of my favorite tracks on IGOR. What's good is really cool. Let's start with the production, and I like it. It's very dark, bombastic, and atmospheric, feeling like a more refined version of a song from Cherry Bomb. And there are also some nice pianos that fit Igor's vibe and make What's Good feel like a combination of the Cherry Bomb and IGOR eras of Tyler's career. Absolutely fantastic production. Tyler also sounds great. His voice is incredibly deep and cool, his rap flow is solid, and he really brings a lot of energy to the song that really makes What's Good stick out in a good way. All in all, an awesome vocal performance. And the lyrics are good too. They're very interesting, Tyler-esque, and fit the vibe of the song perfectly. Just absolutely great lyrics. What's Good is just an absolutely fantastic and catchy song that perfectly blends two eras of Tyler's career into one glorious song. Great work, Tyler. Comparing scars before dinner, jump off the roof into the mirror, felt like summer to my December. Gone Gone / Thank You is really cool. The production is really fun and doo-wop-like while still having Tyler's signature charm. It's very toe-tapping and fun, yet still fits Igor's atmosphere. Easily some of the best production of the album. Tyler also sounds fantastic. His voice is very squeaky, which really fits the laid-back production and really makes the song feel enjoyable. And when he switches to his regular voice, Tyler also sounds really good. His flow is really good, and he perfectly fits the vibe of the song. Great job, Tyler. And the lyrics are cool. They're very interesting, fit the vibe of IGOR, and are all around effective. Gone Gone / Thank You is just an effective and enjoyable bop, which perfectly fits within IGOR, is full of atmosphere, and doesn't overstay its welcome, despite being 6 minutes long. Another album highlight. You do you, I'll do me, I'll just check the piece up. I ain't trying to keep up because I don't love you anymore. I Don't Love You Anymore is a very solid vibe. Let's start with the production, and it's very nice. It has a soothing and relaxing vibe that really fits the album, yet makes the song feel off-kilter in a very satisfying way. It's enjoyable production that perfectly captures the vibe of the song. Tyler also sounds fantastic. His voice is incredibly soft and soothing, and his flow works really well with the song. It's just an overall very nice vocal performance. And the lyrics are cool. Like the other lyrics on Igor's songs, the lyrics to I Don't Love You Anymore are very interesting, combining Tyler's unique writing style with the album's tragic story to create something really interesting. Great lyrics all around. I Don't Love You Anymore is just a very interesting song that beautifully fits within IGOR with great production, fantastic vocals, and interesting lyrics. Definitely an album highlight. Yeah. And so we end, Igor, with the 12th and final track, Are We Still Friends? And yeah, it's a good track to end on. The production is so freaking good, with an incredibly soothing disco R&B flair that brings the album to a light, breezy end, similar to Harmony House's Like Ivy. It's easily some of the best production on Igor, and that's definitely saying a lot. And Tyler sounds amazing. His voice is so smooth and soothing, really fitting the smooth vibe of the song and really making it stand out. And the lyrics are great as well. Basically, the song is about Tyler falling out of love and wanting to just be friends with the person he was formerly in love with. They're really well written and give the album a sense of finality. Just great lyrics all around. Are We Still Friends is just an awesome track that does a great job of concluding both the album and Tyler's story with gorgeous production, nice vocals, and really good lyrics. A great end to a freaking amazing album. Tyler, the Creator's Igor is an absolutely fantastic album. In addition to capturing the same vibey atmosphere that made Flower Boy such an awesome album, Igor ups the lyrical skills of Tyler the Creator and creates a storyline that's insanely fascinating. Igor essentially took the bits of Flower Boy that signified Tyler's evolution and put them on full display, leading to an overall very interesting and unique experience. While Flower Boy is Tyler's best album, at least in my opinion, Igor is an incredibly unique and interesting experience that combines the vibiness and creativity of Tyler with a poignant and interesting story about falling in and out of love. If you haven't heard Igor yet, please do, as it's really freaking good. And that's it. Comment below your thoughts on Igor, as well as your favorite Tyler the Creator project, and tune in for more content when I make it. Till next time, this is Jeremy ending our broadcast day. See ya!